Do you recognize the source of the sound?
That was a doorbell, right?
Yeah, but how does a doorbell work?
I certainly have no idea.
This is a diagrammatic representation of an electric bell.
Here, B is the gong, K is the key, E is the soft iron core, U is the battery or the power supply, T are the electrical contacts, and A is the spring-loaded arm.
But what happens exactly when we close the circuit?
Starts to flow in the circuit. As it flows through the wire, wound on the soft iron core E, the core gets magnetized due to the magnetic effect of current.
The iron core now acts like an electromagnet and induces a strong magnetic field which attracts the armature, also made of soft iron. How the core and the armature get magnetized is a different topic which we will discuss later.
The arm hits the gong B and produces a ringing sound that we hear. Now, there is a beautiful trick in this simple circuit. As soon as the armature hits the gong, it loses contact with the metal screw T and current stops to flow in the circuit.
Electromagnet loses its magnetism and stops attracting the armature. The spring attached with the armature pulls it back into its original position, thus completing the circuit again. This process goes on until the key is opened or the power source gets exhausted.
Well, let us see an animation to understand the process in a better way.
As you can see, when the key is closed, current starts to flow in the wires, which is represented by the color of the wires turning orange.
The iron core is now magnetized and produces magnetic field, which is represented by the blue lines.
Now observe the electrical contact. When the arm hits the gong, it loses the contact with the circuit.
Now back to our question. How does the iron core get magnetized?
Iron is a ferromagnetic substance and contains small regions of magnetic dipoles in the same direction. Each of these small regions are called domains. In the absence of an external magnetic field, these domains are aligned in a random fashion and the resultant effects tend to zero.
But when an external magnetic field is applied, these domains are aligned in the direction of the applied field and the magnetic intensity increases greatly. The substance gets magnetized and starts behaving like a magnet. Now we have some trivia for you.
And there is something special about it. And Ayush will tell us what's so special about it.
Guys, as you can see, this is a bell, but this is not an ordinary electric bell. It is, in fact, the Oxford electric bell. It was made in 1840 and has been ringing since then.
More information can be accessed from the link given here.
Thanks for watching.